today I'm in this session going to talk about WSO2 Process Center. So this is basically a tool to help you run your business. So let's see how you can use this to run your business by using an example. So today our example is our friend Mike. So he got to manage a hotel. Okay. The hotel's owner has interviewed him and chosen him as the CEO of this hotel. Now, the owner of the hotel has given him some goals. So there are a few goals, actually. So one is to make profit for the owner. Then he has to also make the customers happy. And he has to keep the employees happy. So these are the goals of our friend Mike. But when running this hotel, Mike has to do many operations. Like, for example, he has to manage or provide food for guests. So this providing food is not a simple operation. He has to select suppliers, and he has to maintain kitchens, and he has to follow certain procedures, and he has to maybe train staff and hire necessary staff, and so on. Then he has to maintain the hotel. So there can be many problems when you're running a big installation like a hotel. So there can be problems in plumbing and so on. So he has to, again, hire staff for that and build necessary procedures for that. Then he has to work with customers. He has to make the customers happy. So he has to maintain receptions, and he has to maintain hire customer relations staff and so on. Then he also has to hire new employees for running this hotel. So like that, there are many operations involved when you're running a business. In this example, running a hotel. So let's take an example of a situation. So we have a broken air conditioner. So we have a customer who has paid a lot for a room in this hotel, but all of a sudden, the air conditioner has broken. So now what we have is an angry customer. Now she comes in and complains to the receptionist or to the service desk. But now Mike has recently started as a CEO of this hotel, so he doesn't know any of the operations of this hotel, as well as the employees. So now the receptionist has the complaint, but she doesn't have a very good idea what to do with this. So she's in a problem. Okay. See, she basically doesn't know how to contact the maintenance staff and what should be the next step she has to follow, and whether or not she has to inform his manager and so on. She has no idea. So anyway, because she's smart, she calls some maintenance staff and said that there's a problem with this air conditioner. Now we have our maintenance staff, but again, they also don't know what to do because there are no processes in place. So they have some gut feeling, that is, they have to somehow fix the air conditioner. But there can be processes involved. How can they go into the room? And whether they have to make a prior appointment before going into the room and check the air conditioner? And if there are some parts missing, how can they order those items? So there are a lot of things when doing a simple operation like that, but they don't have a clear idea about that. Then somehow, let's say that they need to buy some item to fix this air conditioner. So they inform their manager. So again, the manager also doesn't know what are the exact steps he has to follow. So first of all, maybe he has to contact available suppliers, a list of registered suppliers. Or if it is available in the inventory, he has to fetch it from the inventory and so on. So he doesn't know what are the exact steps he has to follow. So everyone is in trouble now. And also we have our friend Mike there, who wants to know what is going on in this hotel. But again, he also doesn't have any idea. So what are the things that Mike wants to know? So he wants to know, when there's a problem like this, how long does it take in average to fix this? And also he wants to know how frequently such problems occur. And he also wants to know who are the staff involved in such a problem, and so on. So he wants to know all this information, but at the moment, he doesn't know anything. So this is the usual scenario that we get if we are not focusing on our processes. So how to fix it? We have to focus on the process. So this is the process for fixing the broken air conditioner. So first, we have to record the complaint, and then the receptionist has to inform the maintenance guys. Also, she has to contact the manager, and the manager can evaluate the problem, and so on. There are many steps involved. So the first step in going towards a process-oriented organization or managing an organization systematically is to concentrate on your processes. So that is where Process Center helps you. Now, let's say that Mike decides that he can't run this hotel that way, so he has to go for a systematic management approach. So he sits with his management team and starts documenting his processes. So this is the first step where Process Center helps you. It provides a process designer, which allows you to capture processes in multiple methods. So first, he logs into the Process Center and starts creating processes for each of the processes in the organization. Now here, he's dealing with the IT procurement process, so he enters the details about that. Then if you take a process, there can be many interconnections among these processes. For example, in this procurement process, there can be a sub-process for selecting suppliers. So he has to identify all such connections and add those things here as well. So this is the first step. Then he can document the process in many ways. So if he likes to document that using plain text, he can do it. Or if he wants to associate a BPMN model, he can do it as well. So there are many other options as well. He can associate PDF documents, he can create the process flow using flowcharts and so on. There are many ways that he can document processes. So this is the first step in using Process Center for systematic management of an organization. Now he has documented all processes, including our air conditioner fixing process. Okay, now he has done with the documentation. Now he wants to publish it. Now again, as Sumedha mentioned, there are life cycle involved. He can promote the process through these life cycle steps. And if he wants, he can program it in such a way that in some life cycle, some other people has to approve it. Like that, he can go through the life cycle and publish the process. Okay. Now once processes are published, now comes to the other part. That are the normal employees of the organization. Now, who are the employees? As we saw, there are receptionists, maintenance people, and cooks, maybe, and also electricians, and so on. There are many employees in the hotel. Now, let's say that, let's come back to our example of fixing the broken air conditioner. Now, Bob is one of our maintenance people. He wants to buy an item to fix this air conditioner. So now what he does is he logs into the process center. And this is the other part of the process center which provides you a process discovery section, which is called the process explorer. Now he logs into the process explorer. It displays all processes that are authorized for him. So here he can search the processes using keywords or content search or anything. Then he can find the process he's looking for. Now he's looking for a procurement process. Now he can look at the steps involved in this process. Now what he has to do is that simply read this documentation and get to know what are the next steps he has to follow. Okay, there are multiple ways to describe in this process as well. So if the process is described using text, it is available like text, and there can be BPMN models associated as well. So there are multiple ways. So the Bob can go to the whatever format he prefers and look at the process and decide on the next steps. Now, okay, now our Mike has documented all processes. So he knows what are the processes available and what are the steps. And all employees knows what to do when something goes wrong or when something has to be done. Now Bob, Mike thinks whether we can automate some of these processes. So this is another area where Process Center can help you. So this is the deployment architecture of the process center. So we have our process center at the middle. Now, what Mike has done is he has get along with his management team and created a collection of processes. Now, we have our process participants who can be receptionist, maintenance staff, and so on. They can access these processes and get to know what are the steps to be followed in these processes. So this is the topmost part. Then when you are doing that, so this is a collaborative tool. That means the users can give ratings or give comments to processes and so on, so that the processes can be iteratively improved. So now we have improved process collection there. Now our next step is to automate these processes. Now Mike hires some developers and asks them to automate these processes. So the developer also logs into the process center and accesses the process that he wants to automate. Now once he accesses the process, he gets all information regarding the process, the steps, flowcharts if available, or abstract BPM models and so on. He gets all those information. Now he can use WSO2 Developer Studio and model this process as an executable model in BPMN. So once he's done, he can upload the executable model back to the process center and associate that with the process available in the process center. So once it is done, Mike or someone from the management team can deploy that in a business process server, which is the process runtime. Now this process server and the process center are connected so that the process center knows in which process servers a particular process is deployed in. Now that is the automation step. Now we come to our example again. Now Bob wants to order an item. So what he does is that he connects to the process center and finds the process for procuring an item. So he finds the process. Then he can check whether there's an associated executable process for this particular process. So if there's an associated executable process, he can just execute the process from within the process center. So it will be executed in process servers so that necessary people can participate in that process, in that automated process, and complete the process. So this is how automation is supported using process center. Now, okay, now, we have our processes documented, and our staff knows how to work with these processes. Also, we have some processes automated. Now, Mike wants to know what is going on in this organization. Now, the process is automated, but still, Mike doesn't know exactly how this organization operates. So this is where process analytics comes in. So this process center comes in with some analytics components. For that, we use WSO2 Data Analytics Server. So this is the deployment setup for this analytics part. So we have a process center there. And we have the process server, which executes the processes. And now we have our Bob executing the procurement process. Now, once he executes the process, it is the process center connects to the process server and sends the signal to execute the process. Now the process is executing there. Now, as and when the process is executed there, this process server publishes events related to this process to the data analytics server. So the data analytics server maintains a store of events. Now the process center also deploys some analytics scripts into the data analytics server so that it does some summarization and some analytics and so on and generates some summarized results. Then there are a collection of dashboards available in the process center which accesses those summarized results and creates some visual dashboards for authorized people. Now what Mike has to do is that log into the process center and access the dashboards for the processes that he's interested in. So this is the analytics part. Now these are a few dashboards available. Now here we are checking what are the processes that took most of the time. So because we collect information about all processes, we can summarize or average out the execution times of each process. Now here we know that this process takes most of the time. Now we can further analyze it or drill down it. Now a process is a collection of tasks. Now if you want to analyze the execution time of a process, one obvious way is to analyze the execution times of individual tasks. Now that is what Mike is doing here. He wants to analyze what are the bottlenecks of the process. That means the task that took most of the time. So here knows that the place order task has taken most of the time. Now he wants to further analyze it. Now what he analyzes here is who are the users taking most of the time to complete this particular task. Because a particular task can be completed by multiple users in multiple process instances. Now by looking at that, he knows that one user has taken most of the time. So like that, he can analyze and drill down this information and identify what are the exact bottlenecks or problems in his organization. So that is the analytics part that is supported by Process Center. Then, okay, now Mike knows what is going on. Now Mike wants to know whether he can improve things. So that is also supported by Process Center. That means by the means of process optimization. Now let's say that we have a process like this. So this is for ordering items. Yeah. So what happens is that over the time, many instances of this process will be executed in the organization. And all events related to these executions will be stored in the event store associated with the data analytics server. Now, by looking into these events, we can apply prediction algorithms like decision tree mining or regression models and do some predictions about the process. For example, now let's say that we get an order for this Toshiba T100 laptop in month November. Now, once we get that data, we can tap into the already available events and apply those prediction algorithms and decide how much time will it take to package these items if the order is for Toshiba laptop and the order is placed in November. So it says that it takes around 2.5 days to package items. Then again, we can also check the time, the predicted time for shipping this item if we have to ship it to San Francisco in November. Because we already have past data, we can apply those prediction algorithms and come up with such predictions using Process Center. And once we know the average execution times for individual tasks, for example, we can say that after this point, the estimated remaining time of the process can be 7.9 days. So like that, so this is also useful because let's say that we have a customer waiting on order. Now he wants to know how much time he has to wait. So then we can apply these prediction algorithms and tell him estimated time for waiting. So there are other things as well. That means we can also apply recommendation algorithms, which allows you to make the right call at right time. For example, let's again take this procurement process. Now let's say that we have an order running, and the customer wants to complete this order within 4 days. Now we are in this task, which is order items. Now here, the staff has to select different suppliers. Now the Process Center can apply those recommendation algorithms and say, if you want to complete this order within 4 days, you have to select this particular supplier. Otherwise, you can't meet that goal. In the same way, when it comes to shipping items, again, the Process Center can help the staff to select different shippers. Shipping lines. For example, it may say that if you want to achieve that goal, you have to select the shipping line K lines. Otherwise, you won't be able to achieve that goal. So that is one area. So this is another area. That means so we have a whole collection of process models, and we have a whole collection of events that is coming into the Process Center from running business processes. Now, what the Process Center can do is that it can correlate these models with the events. Now, by doing that, it can apply process discovery algorithms, which allows us to create process models out of events. And by doing that, it may be able to identify some missing tasks in a process. For example, if you consider this process, it has three tasks already modeled, but the Process Center is receiving some events to an unknown task. Now, Process Center can correlate those with the existing events and say that you have to insert another task in between This is a transport to port and ship package task because it is receiving events for that task. So like that, it can help you in improving or completing your existing models as well. So this is how it can help you in optimize your business. So that is about using Process Center for running a business. So in summary, this is what Mike has done. So we have Mike, who is the CEO of this hotel. He first started with designing processes. So after that step, Mike knows all his processes. So for that, he uses the process designer component of the Process Center. Then after that, he publishes the processes so that the employees of his hotel can discover the processes and work according to them. So everyone knows what to do after this step. Then Mike decides to automate some of his processes. So the developers can again access the process designer and get all information and automate and associate the executable models with the Process Center. So after this step, all the automated processes can run efficiently. Then Mike wants to know what is going on in the process in his organization. So he uses the process analysis features available in Process Center. So after that, Mike knows what is going on. Then again, Mike uses this process optimization features of the Process Center, which allows him to improve existing processes. So the output of that is another or improved collection of processes, which can begin with the process design phase again. So this is called the BPM life cycle, and this can be supported using the Process Center, as I mentioned here. So yeah, that is all about it, about running your business with Process Center.